Hi, welcome to Free Spirit, and welcome to this beautiful spirit message and a couple of cards that I want to show you to bring this home. But this is actually how to be protecting yourself from toxicity, even online. These are top 10 uplifting spirit messages and tips, and this is a lifetime of actually experiencing this, living this, and so I just wanted to share it and leave it on the channel, whether today, tomorrow, next week, next month. It's just here for whenever anyone's guided and really needs to hear this and feel supported. And the importance of this, I actually have notes because it is such a recurring theme, but it's never been really fully discussed here. But I really wanted to share what I've been personally doing and constantly working on to be as pure and clear and energized as possible in life itself, in real life reality, because what I'm about to share is very real. It is very real, and it is so damaging and dangerous, actually, to not realize just how real it is and to the degree that it is. And I really want to speak really frankly about it. And I'll put in the description box the top 10 that I wrote down that really sums up the top 10 to bring it down, and I'll elaborate a little bit on each one. okay, the first one. This is literally all about how to be protecting yourself from toxicity, even online. Top 10 uplifting spirit messages and tips. And the first one is let it go. You know, like that song, let it go, letting it go. But I also say drop it and drop it. Meaning if you've digested something that's negative or toxic, drop it and then literally drop it again, and you're not rehashing it. So this doesn't mean, like, if something happens and you've encountered negativity or toxicity, if you feel the need to talk it out with someone you trust and just to get it out, or write it out, or, you know, explain how you feel to somebody so you could just get it out, of course, but you let it go. From that point on, you let it go. So it's drop it and then drop it. Drop it again, meaning you're not going to go back and rehash this. You're not going to be discussing this tomorrow, next week, next month, rehashing it. There are many reasons for that. So they always told me it's not just let it go, but it's let it go and let it go. And also, when you drop it, again, say you're dropping it and drop it and drop it two times, because you really need to drop what you're digesting literally at the moment, let it go and drop it, and then drop it again. Like, you're not going to rehash it in your mind, in your heart, after you've spoken about it already once. It's not to be spoken about again and again, because you're only digesting it yourself over and over again. So yeah, these seem like light things to do, but when you actually do this for yourself, you're going to feel a difference in your energy. Number two, they say greet the sun before you greet negative comments and emails. So whether this is online or face to face, greet the sun before you greet the negativity. So some of us roll over and you're just quickly digesting alerts on your phone, emails, negative comments from your social media things. They literally brought it down to just greet the sun before you greet the negativity. So start your day positive. Don't necessarily reach for that right away. If you know some things are just a negative channel of that, wait till you have literally seen the sun out your window first, grabbed a cup of coffee, did your exercise, listened to uplifting music. Like, feed yourself some positivity first before you greet any kind of negative channel input. Because very often I was guilty of just rolling over and, like, looking at comments that were just disgusting, emails that are just stressful, or, you know, that kind of input. And you don't have to reach for that first. Literally, you can greet the sun. I thought that was very funny. Greet the sun before you greet negative comments and emails. Yeah, you can feed yourself first. Take a moment to look out the window, literally see the sun. Get a cup of coffee, you know, something before you greet any potential negativity. Number three, when you do encounter negativity and toxicity, you do not have to actually respond at all. And that is a very off the hook, kind of letting yourself off the hook. Like, a lot of times people are just spewing stuff and you don't even have to respond at all. It could just land in emptiness. It's of no importance and of no magnitude. It doesn't land, but truly it doesn't land, and you don't have to respond at all. You don't have to waste more of your time, focus, attention, your energy. But they always are bringing home with this, your energy is so important. We don't realize how much things pull at us until it's too late. This can really take a toll on your physical, mental health, It's really damaging. That's why they're going on about it. But you don't have to actually respond at all. Four, if you are responding, you can remain in calm, love, truth, facts, over emotion and retaliation. So if you want to respond to someone and they're coming at you, whether face-to-face or online, you can, you know, especially if you've greeted the sun first, you filled your cup, you're coming from love, peace, calm, everything else, you can respond with just truth and facts and calm and peace over any kind of emotion or retaliation, if you want to, you know, correct them on something or anything else. But it doesn't have to, you don't have to add any over emotion to it, retaliation for it. You could just clearly respond and then go back to let it go, drop it and drop it, you know. And then number five, evaluate and honestly see where all this negativity is coming from and then put up boundaries. So if you're finding it's coming from a particular source, you can stop that source or you can put boundaries to your relationship with that source. So in terms of putting boundaries to your relationship with that source, can you change the amount of time that it has access to you or even has access to you at all? You know, if there are particularly, say, some channels of social media where that's just inundated all the time, you can end your relationship with that channel. Or you can limit the access to you. You know, there are settings on things. Or if it's coming from a particular person, you can limit the amount of time that they even have access to you. You can put boundaries. So it leads to number six, which is claim back your power, that you can stand with your guardian angel, actually, of the gates more of what comes into your life and make decisions about it. This card is the guardian angel card, but it's all about literally, and we get this all the time, the last two cards are the ones they want me to show you at the end. But this is literally, we talk about guardian angels, but this is taking a stand with your guardian angel at the gates of your own life to decide what to let in and out of your life. So speak up, stand strong and firm and guard the gates of what comes and goes. They want us to take a stand and claim your power at the gates of your life. You don't just wish for that to happen. You honestly assess, you know, you can claim back your power and stand at the gates of what's coming in more. Make more of a stand, you know, claim back your power. You can stand at the gates more of what comes into your life and make decisions about it. It leads to number seven. Only you know how you honestly feel. So be honest on how it makes you feel. So a lot of the times, I mean, that's just, it's a big one, actually, because a lot of times we brush off things or we're just like, oh, whatever, we can rise above it, we can let it go. But, you know, how do you honestly feel about it? How do you honestly, and how is it honestly making you feel? You don't have to discount if something is constantly making you feel lousy or lowering your spirit. Like, why would you put much more effort on your spirit that you have to uplift yourself over and over so much more if something is being so outrageously negative? Only you know how you honestly feel. And that's a loaded sentence because other people can be just fine with it. You know, other people can honestly just be so fine with it. They, you know, it doesn't make them feel the way it makes you feel. But the thing is, you have to be honest on how it makes you feel. And only you can know that and be there for yourself, taking a stand with your guardian angel. Number eight, it leads to number eight. It doesn't matter what others' opinions are about it. It doesn't matter what other opinions are about what you do to protect and guard yourself. You have to know honestly how you feel. Be honest, how is it making you feel? And it doesn't matter what others' opinions are about it and what you're doing to protect and guard yourself. You don't need their approval, and you don't let them have to approve of, you know, where you're coming from or what you need to feel protected or guarded. They don't know how you honestly feel. They're not in your skin. It's for you to honor what you're honestly feeling in your own skin and how it's making you feel. It's part of being more in power and more in control more than you think. And it's up for us to take care of our energy. It is so valuable. Like, it is just not okay to be negatively affected over and over again, because it does affect you physically, mentally, emotionally, and takes its toll. So I can't understate that enough. And number nine, you can do all you can. That you almost have permission to do this, and you have full support. You can do all you can to maintain and stabilize your energy as calm, peace, love, kindness. You know, and that takes work. Like I always say, it's light work 24/7, but you do, this is what you're here for, your energy, you do all you can to maintain and stabilize the energy, your energy, to be calm, peace, love, kindness. So that is taking in all I mentioned before of you have to honestly know how it's making you feel. Then you have to stand up and claim your power of what you're allowing in and out to affect you like that. You can establish proper boundaries. You can limit access. It leads to number 10. You can now actively reach for more that helps you achieve this state of energy. You can uplift yourself, right? You can give yourself permission to do all you can to maintain and stabilize your energy as calm, peace, love, kindness, and actively reach for more that helps you achieve this state of energy. You can uplift yourself. She's putting a guard here and uplifting herself. So these are my 10 that I hold on to. This I learned over the course of my lifetime and in a very harsh way sometimes because of how important it is, because your energy is all you have. It can affect you physically, mentally, emotionally when you don't realize the real grim reality of this. These are my 10 that I hold on to. We don't realize just how much we have incoming all the time and to what degree it is so negative and toxic. We have almost become dehumanized and desensitized to it. We cannot wait until people realize just how damaging it is to help eliminate the actual damage it causes to people. Negative words mean something, you know, whether carried face to face or online, and even more so online, because people feel freer to be meaner and harsher, and they even score more points to be the most outrageous or hurtful with zingers. And one day, people will realize the importance of their energy and words they dish out that pollutes everything and everyone. And until then, protect yourself and honor yourself. You deserve better and are standing up and making sure you give better to yourself to counteract that reality. And that's the sum, that's like the theme, because they were saying always and always to me, until then, you can't be Pollyanna and pretend it doesn't exist, it doesn't affect you the way that it does, that it's not, you know, all these things. You can want people to change, you want them to open their heart, you want them to be more kind and be, you know, all these things, right? But that's great, but until then, protect yourself, honor yourself, you deserve better, and are standing up and making sure that you give better to yourself to counteract the reality. And it is the reality, right? So they're saying, take a stand. Now they led me to the cards to show you. You take a stand with your guardian angel at the gates of your own life to decide what to let in and out of your life. You speak up, you stand strong and firm, and you guard the gates of what comes and goes. This leads to breakthroughs, right? It's a breakthrough time. There's new light coming in where there was none before. This is new ideas, new knowledge, and wisdom coming in. Why? To focus on love. You get back to this. Let your day begin and end on love. No matter what's going on in the physical world, it does not matter. You have the power to claim all this back. You have the power to let your day, no matter what's going on in the world, in the physical, and what people are dishing out, and what people are saying, and what they're all about, let your day begin and end on love. This is the key to remaining in tune to love and highest levels. And let each day rise and set on love, focus on the love, and let the rest go. And it's ending just how it began. The number one thing was let it go, letting it go. And what I also say is drop it and drop it. So if you digest something comes at you, you let it go, focus back on the love, drop it and drop it. So this has been, you know, this seems very light. It may seem really trivial. It's very hard to, you know, put this all in one video. But I'm telling you, these are life-saving, actually, from physical, mental, emotional tolls that this does take, this negativity, this toxicity that's constantly bombarding us all the time, in a very practical way. Of ways, literally, how to be protecting yourself from toxicity, even online. And these are the top 10. I wanted to bring it down to a top 10 uplifting spirit messages and tips. It is things that I wish somebody told me. It is something that I wish somebody told me. Because very often we're not on our own side. We are brushing a lot more off ourselves. We're putting a lot more, we're allowing much more in than is healthy. And we can't wait for other people to change, you can't wait until then. You have to make the changes in your life and stand up for yourself of what you're allowing in, and you deserve better. So you provide for yourself the counteractive energy that you're digesting. So this has been How to Be Protecting Yourself from Toxicity, Even Online, Top 10 Uplifting Spirit Messages and Tips. And I just wanted to share it all here with you. And I wish you all the best, and I wish you to stay uplifted no matter what. And I'll end it with the thing: actively reach for more that helps you achieve this state of energy, of calm, of peace, of love, of kindness. You can still be that. You know, what happens too, that I started getting very jaded, because when you allow this energy in, it pollutes your own energy. And you have less to give. You have less to be there for yourself. You have less to give to others. So this helps you and others. It really is the most beautiful thing to take care of your own energy, and the importance of taking care of your own energy. So this is like the best summation I could possibly do of like life lessons that I've had to learn the hard way, that they drill in my head and heart over and over and over again. It takes a million different kinds of experiences to get you back to this. The importance of actually doing this for sanity, for your physical health, for your mental health, for your emotional health. That literally, and the importance of actively reaching for more that helps you achieve the state of energy for yourself. And we can't wait for others to change. It's for us to make the modifications as we go. So yeah, so I wanted to share this with you, the permission and how the support literally there is for how to be protecting yourself from toxicity, even online, face-to-face, online, in whatever relationship you have. You always can take a stand with your guardian angel of what comes and goes. And so that's why they guided me to these cards. You take a stand with your guardian angel. You decide, no matter what's coming at you, you take a stand. You decide what to let in and out of your life. You speak up, you stand strong, firm, guard the gates of what comes and goes. That's the breakthrough, that you have the power. That's the wisdom. That's the ideas of what, how to handle it. New knowledge, wisdom, you act on it. That's the light in the dark, in the negativity, in the toxicity of how to handle it, the top 10. And you get back to letting your day begin and end on love. You focus on the love for yourself, letting it go, reaching for higher, staying in this vibration, because that's the healthy vibration. That is the healthy vibration. That's releasing, truly releasing the negativity and the toxicity that we absorb or come at us. That's remaining in tune to love in the highest levels. You just let every day rise and set on love, focus on the love, and let the rest go. And this has been How to Be Protecting Yourself from Toxicity, Even Online. And I just wanted to share this with you. Focus on the love and take care of yourself. Take care of yourself. Absolutely. Take care. Bye-bye.